Assalamualaikum everyone, welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to share with you guys a very interesting story. 2017 was the year when I was alone and pretty far from my hometown Taiwan. And it was the first year that I didn't spend the Lunar New Year with my family, so I was super homesick. And when I heard about there was an HBO series which was going to be in full Mandarin and it was based on Taiwanese culture, so I was super excited. Yeah, and that's the series which is called The Teenage Side Chick.
你生来就跟别人不一样，你生来是带天命。
熬夜，熬夜，
反正我做什么事情都要反对啊！
看好他！
From Teenage Psychic, premiere Sunday, April 2nd.
Well, if you guys are curious about this Taiwanese culture series, I really suggest you to watch. And of course, it's super different from Islam. So, well, welcome to tell me how do you think afterwards, okay? Anyway, I'm going to share you guys her story, her reverted story. Her name is Liu Bojun, and you can also call her Sophia. I'm not so sure how to pronounce in Arabic. Anyway, she's well known in Taiwan, not only because of her psychic power.
大概是我三岁左右吧，家人发现我的世界非常拥挤，多看了一些他们不看不到的人，他们有时候会追着我跑啊，那有些长得很凶恶，我会害怕，脸绿绿的，然后还对着你笑。误打误撞之下呢，我就成为一个通灵人。15岁的时候就因为信徒多了，所以就直接开了一间公庙，一直到我大学毕业。
But also her position in Taiwan society. She is the first female international umpire who is confirmed by Chinese Taipei Baseball Association and the first played umpire of national matches in Taiwan. Well, yeah, she's really, really impressive, right? Sophia talked about her experience at the book fair in Taiwan where she was introducing her own book. She said, it all started at an international book fair. She passed by a Jordanian stand. There was a Jordanese who took care of the stuff. She was like, why would let a terrorist settle a stand here? But she was curious about the religion, so he stopped by. This Jordanese friend asked her if she was interested to Islam. She replied that she would like to know more about Quran. He passed her a Quran with English translation and he wanted to give her as a gift. He said, you will become a Muslim if Allah wants, inshallah. But she refused to get it for free because she doesn't like to own people. So she insisted to buy the Quran. She even told him, I don't think I will believe in a religion which is sexual racism towards the woman. She couldn't understand the content of Quran while reading it back then, so she just kept it at home until it became her life guide. Because after a few years, she was tired of working at the temple, so she started to try different religions, but she had no feelings for any of them. That was the reason why she decided to go on the academic way, and she got into Graduate Institute of Religion Study of National 政治 University. 政治 University is one of the top university in Taiwan. So basically, she was pretty proud of her more than 10 years of real experiences with the unseen creatures, but she couldn't find the direction on the academy. It made her confused again. At once, it was Ramadan. The Taipei Mosque invited the students for a visit. She didn't take it too serious. It was just an ordinary event of the class. As a side chick, she always has a habit that she will call those unseen creatures and ask them questions every time when she is in a new place to show her power. However, she saw nothing at the mosque. She was upset. She couldn't believe there was no ghost, not even one. At this point, she noticed the difference of the mosque. But she was still not happy after the visit. So she stayed at the mosque watching Muslims' prayers in Ramadan. She waited until dark, but she still didn't see what she wanted. She couldn't hold it but ask an imam how they explain about ghosts in Islam. Imam told her, the chapter 72 of the Quran is talking about jinn. Jinn is like the ghost as what we know. Hadith also mentions that jinn eats ashes. She was shocked by that, because from what she knew about unseen world, some of ghosts do rely on incense. She even thought about to open a temple with no paper money, idols, but her own way to adore God. She smiled. Luckily, I didn't share this to anyone, otherwise I would be the fake version, because the mosque have done those stuff. Really interesting. Afterwards, Sophia also found out that reading Quran makes her pretty calm, and she was really touched by it. She kept asking herself, why I am not a Muslim yet? She tried to communicate with her family once she decided to revert, but her mom said, you can believe whatever, but why you choose terrorist religion? She replied, I can't really make choice, but it's the only place where it makes me feel peace. Religion is like having a relationship. It's a kind of feeling. Besides the rational understand, there is always a sensible and deep connection that other people can't feel or understand. But it's a life change experience for a person. I totally agree with this. After Sophia reverted, she was advised by the imam to read the last three chapters in Quran. She hoped she could walk away from the disturbing of the unseen. When she visited her relatives who adore a lot of gods, because in Taiwan our belief is like a lot of gods, different kind of gods. Her relative asked her if she could still see anything after reverting to Islam. She saw around. There was a Tudigong, the god of the earth, at distance. The relative wanted her to invite Tudigong for tea. Tudigong told her that she had light on her. He was not there to approach. When I read about this, I was like, oh, wow. You know, like, Tudigong, you know, the god in my childhood, is scared of her light. Yeah, and she believes in the creator of the universe. So, you know what I mean? She noticed how Islam was changing her day after day. She wanted to live her own life and stop the service for the folk believers' desire. Then she started reading hadith, and the description about jinn is really similar to her experiences. For instance, hadith mentions that do not eat with left hand, because jinn will come to share. We should sleep on the right side of our bodies. She was pretty surprised too, because there were a lot of ghosts and jinns asked her to use left hand to eat and sleep on her belly, but she didn't know why. She also found out that Islam has meant a lot of protect women's rights 1,400 years ago. Most of oppression were from the tribal folks and the male scholars' interpretation. Her woman racism tag on Islam is no longer exist. The most important value in Islam is to adore the true one God. Human is just his creation, so we have to be humble. We are all responsible to Allah. No need to pray for others. This spirit is always reflected on the prayers. Muslims follow the sequence at the mosque. Even if you are rich and you arrive after a poor man, you still need to stay behind him. She memorized the days when she was working in the temple. The believers asked for happy marriage, position, rise, fortune. Those wishes for her now are not important. We are living for Allah, not the fame in this life, she said. We are not born with positions and fortune, so we can't bring them with us after our death. The only thing we can carry with is the good and evil in this life. Everything will be revealed in front of Allah, and He will make the right judgment. So that's her reverted story. Actually, when I just reverted, there were a lot of stuffs I need to digest it. I was more like an atheist, you know? And the reason why I reverted was because I found that Islam also matched with my thoughts about life and stuff. And one day my sister told me about her, Sophia. She was also a reverted Muslim, and I was so curious, so I went on the internet to check her on. I really need to thank her for the explanation with a Taiwanese culture way. And you guys heard that? That's my cat. And yeah, and I also need to thank Allah has been leading me. Yeah, well, even now I'm still practicing. It really takes some time, but I'm pretty sure that I'm on the right side. Anyways, we all know that the Ramadan is coming. So yes, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon. Asama, bye bye, ciao. Asalama, bye bye. Mm. 好可爱哦. Bye bye, peace. Long time no see, no?
Yep. How are you? How are you doing?
We're doing fine, thank you. Yeah. Hey.